Hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Tenacious Fox bringing another video. This time I'm going to be doing a how-to video because one of my viewers asked me, how do you get the Pokemon games randomized? And it was actually one of my friends. So first of all, you're going to want to come to this page. This is where you get the randomizer. It's an actual program that randomizes the ROMs. This link will be in the description of this video. And if you're on Windows, you're going to click on this. And it's gonna download. Unfortunately, I've got really slow Wi-Fi at home. But luckily, I already have it. So when it downloads, you can just drag it from the bottom screen. It's going to be down here. You can just drag it and put it on your desktop. It may come in a zip file, and with that you're going to need a program called WinRAR to open it and extract it. So when you downloaded it, extracted it, you're going to get a application like this. See, this is the folder I have it in. So it should be in an EXE, not a jar. Mine's a jar, but it should download. If you're using Windows, it'll download it as an EXE. If you're not using Windows, it'll download as a jar. And if it's a jar, you're gonna need Java to open it. So here we have it open. I'm gonna go here, open ROM. I've got Game of Color, so I've got a number of different games, but for this we're gonna do Pokemon Silver, since that's the LP that I'm currently doing. So here you have the basic things. So if you want to really, really randomize it, there's a lot of people doing that. You can do basic statistics random. You can do types random, you can do evolutions random, and basically you do all that stuff here. Here you've got your starter Pokemon, so you can do a random, you can do it so it's basic Pokemon, you can put starter held items, you can ban the bad items. Here's static Pokemon. You can either do random for legendaries to legendaries, so like if you're gonna find a static legendary Pokemon, you can randomize it so it's always a legendary Pokemon, and if it's a normal Pokemon, you can randomize it so it's always a normal Pokemon, or you can just do what I do and do random completely. So here's the trades. You're going to want to randomize that, both the requested and the given Pokemon. I always randomize all these boxes. And moves, for most of my, if you're doing a really random, completely randomized, like typing and stuff, you're gonna want to click all these as well. I'm not going to at this moment. And you're gonna want to randomize these as well if you're doing a completely randomized thing. I'm not, because I'm only randomizing the encounters and the training Pokemon. So here you can, here's the training Pokemon. Now you can do it type themed. So that would mean all the trainers would have a specific type of Pokemon, which means all the gyms would also use a specific type of Pokemon. I've done these before, it's kind of fun. For this, I'm only going to do a random. So you can make it so that your rival carries the same Pokemon. You can make it so they use similar Pokemon with similar strength. So like, but Pokemon that they would normally have, they'll use similar strength to what they normally have in the game. You can click this to do not use legendaries. I never do. I like the challenge. Randomize trainer names, class names. This is something new that's on the new randomizer, or the new version of randomizer. So you can set this to a certain level, and if they have a Pokemon like at that level, it will forcefully be fully evolved. So like, let's say they have an older version of the randomizer, let's say a trainer would have like a level 36 Caterpie. Well, if you click this, then because it's over level 35, it will be forcefully evolved into a Butterfree. So you don't run into like late game, first form Pokemon. And then here you've got a level modifier. I think this does it by percentage, but I'm not completely sure. So if you do this, it'll be 10% stronger, 20%, 30%. Yeah, it actually is, because it says right there. But yeah, that's 30. Let's do 30% for this. It's actually kind of high. So then you come here to the wild Pokemon. Now you can actually do this type thing as well. I rarely do. I just do random. I don't do the similar strength. I don't do any of this stuff except for randomized held items, and I don't do bad items. Then you've got TMs and HMs. You're gonna wanna keep this one. You're gonna wanna check that, because otherwise you can get into a situation where you can't go on. I don't do these. And then TM, HM, compatibility, I don't change this at all either. And then field items, randomize, I ban bad items. And then these are just miscellaneous things. These are new to the newest version of randomizer. So once you've gotten everything that you want to do in your randomizer, you're gonna go to here, randomize save. And I'm just gonna actually save it to my desktop. So I'm gonna save in a Pokemon Silver. What are we gonna call it? Sample. You don't have to do this. Just hit done. Then here we've got our randomized silver version. So I'm gonna make this a little bit larger. Here, I'm just gonna speed through this. So now you're gonna see that's not normally a Jolteon, so you can tell that it's been randomized. We're just gonna say silver. Sorry for the So here we've got where you get your Pokemon, and I'm just showing you that it's all randomized. See, these are normally Cyndaquil, Chikorita, and Totodile. Now I've got a Kingler, a Venomoth, and an Ekans. So this is just to show you that it does in fact randomize the things. And that's actually it. So if you like this video, if it was helpful, please give me a like. If you want to see more videos, give me a subscribe and check out the rest of my channel. Check out my Twitter page as well. Follow me on Twitter. And that's all, guys. See you later.